You found something interesting.
Did you now? Well, color me interested.
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyways.
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. It means hunting death. Great.
Boy.
Sir. Curse the Dwarf King. Bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
No. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused.
Wow. Begin to build statues this big.
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying, but resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves. I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants, and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted in him. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation, and new levels of depravity.
You did well.
There he goes. How is he planning on doing this himself? Topple over.
Do not fall this easily, boy.
I know. I was just joking.
Nor are they a joking matter.
Sorry. Okay. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear. But I can just tell you this story later.
That sounds like a dragon.
Give him what for?
one chained up too?
There's something over there.
Atreus, to me.
More of those. And it sounds so sad.
Surely not sad from all the roaring and fire breathing, lad.
Not very many graves here. This must have been a small settlement.
Yes,
sir. guess this actually was a pretty big setup. And the other. This should be easy to solve now. He got so many of them killed?
It is a command to have faith despite his failures.
Focus up!
Here, boy. Another one.
Skadi. Mother liked her. A great huntress.
That's right. Queen of the Hunt, they called her.
That's her father. And all the animals she hunted.
He taught her well.
And the last panel. Her father again. Both of them. In the snow.
And they're still there. It's quite a story.
This place?
A ruin.
Well, yeah. What if a dwarf built it? It must have been impressive back when he ruled.
Sorry, not ready!
Look here.
Yes, sir. The Dwarf King made his subjects hunt dragons and other monsters for him? Some king, huh? See this. Looks like that lever over there will free him.
He will attack.
I know, but it feels wrong to keep something caged like this.
Your emotions again, boy.
I can't hear their thoughts. I can't.
Ignore them and ready yourself.
Okay. Thank you, Father. Fresh air feels good.
Run!
Focus up, boy.
It'd be dangerous to destroy the other ones.
If it was your mother's wish.
Yeah.
You are too eager, boy. It may attack us and we will be forced to kill it.
Good point. I'll be ready.
You will see.
Follow me, Atreus.
On my way.
Ah.
was that?
You have to.
That's the last one. I guess now we find out if dragons can be grateful or not.
Yes, sir.
Please don't eat us. Please don't eat us.
Boy, prepare yourself.
So, what happened to all the people who lived here?
Follow the clues, boy.
Right, right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then... And then I don't know.
Hmm. We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
No. There is nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chained dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this Dwarf King.
Could you take a look at this?
What you got for old Brock? See, you boys ran afoul of some travelers. Or them travelers ran afoul of you, more like.
Who are they? What do they want?
Dunno. Boy, you ask a lot of questions. Now, what else do I want to tell you?
Father, why did the gods cause so much trouble for us?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Okay, so Freya left, and Odin was mad.
Furious. And he cursed her most terribly.
But your magic was so much stronger than hers.
Well, I can just tell you this story later.
You there? Have you...
The statue stands no longer, Spirit.
Then my bond to this realm is severed. And I am off to find the real God of Thunder. He will know retribution. My deepest gratitude.
Off he goes. Brave God. Want to look for Thor on his own.
He is a fool.
What did the spear leave us?
An offering to one of the gods.
Can we use it?
No, but perhaps the dwarves can.